Aaron, thank you. Today for your garden, we're talking about a signature fall flower. We're talking about mums, of course. They're so pretty there on that part of the OU campus. They make a fabulous display on the OU campus every fall, and they can also bring a dramatic splash of color to your garden or front porch. And our friend gardening guru Linda Vodder is here. And Linda, for non-gardening people like myself, I understand mums are short for chrysanthemums.
Chrysanthemums, yeah. You got it right. But let me tell you a story. Today I went to buy these for this segment, and the checkout lady asked me, she said, I found out something today about mums I didn't know. And I said, what? And she said that you can plant them. And it never occurred to me that people would think you couldn't plant them. Uh-huh. But they fall into that category of what I call purchase, plop, and pitch. People think of them as a short-term plant that mm-hmm. they kind of just decorate their garden with for the season and then they get rid of them. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't have to be the case. So after they're finished in your front yard or by your front door or whatever, you can plant them.
Yes.
If that's not the location you want them to live long-term, put them in your backyard and, you know, just like any plant, plant them well. Mm-hmm. And then, but the tip is to get them to bloom next fall, you need to keep them cut back to about half their size until the end of July.
Till the end of July. Okay.
If you don't want to do that, then feel free to pitch them or compost them after, because they are just everywhere this time of year. Mm-hmm. They're beautiful, they're inexpensive, and they're a great way to add colorful punch to your front landscape.
Absolutely. And I've seen some already out in our neighborhood, and they are spectacular.
They're spectacular. Yes. But this is another buying tip, because when I went today, the temperatures have been so hot.
They really have been.
They've been sitting out in really brutal conditions. Some of them haven't been watered or taken care of. So make sure that you're not getting a plant that's distressed beforehand. Make sure that they're well hydrated, that there's no broken branches, and that basically it's a really healthy plant. The other thing, Kevin, I know it's hard to resist when they're all already in bloom and they look mm-hmm. beautiful like this, but you really want them to last for the duration of fall or for as long as possible. So when you buy them in tight bud form,
okay,
where they're just starting to show color, so you make sure you get the hue that you want to get, uh-huh, but you want to prolong that bloom as long as possible.
And the blooms get very big.
Oh, the blooms will get big.
Yeah.
Here's another kind of a tip that I've noticed over the years. If you want the color, the intensity of the color and the drama of it to look good for a longer period of time, watch the colors that you select. So the ones that are already kind of a brown and russet color, as the flowers start to die, they don't look so good.
Right.
So you might want something like a yellow or mm-hmm. a white that will really pop in the landscape.
Yes.
That color will travel far and really make a beautiful impact in your front yard.
How much should you expect to pay for one of these?
Well, right now they're on sale. So you can go like these today. I think they were $3 for $10.
Oh, okay.
You can buy them. You can buy mammoth mums in hanging form. You can buy them already potted in decorative containers. You can buy them already potted up with other companions like kale or ivy or some of the beautiful fall grasses right now. So you can buy basically what I think of as an instant garden. But if you want to really kind of tweak it a little bit and do something special, young peeps kind of really like this, plant kind of an ombre effect.
Okay.
Where you're starting with a deep yellow, then you go to a pale yellow and into white, or kind of get it an edgy modern vibe by putting them in galvanized buckets, really inexpensive. Paint one of those orange pumpkins with a spray paint that looks like galvanized metal.
Linda, we appreciate it. Linda Vodder's blog is potagerblog.com. Did I get that right?
You got it.
You can get other great gardening ideas on Linda's blog, as we said, and that is the address for you. We have it at KFOR.com/links.